So from Excel, if we select the Developer tab, and from the left of the ribbon on the menu, if we select Visual Basic, and if you double click and select Sheet 1, and from there we need to type, or I'm just going to copy in this piece of code. Now this piece of code, essentially, it recalculates the worksheet, and we recalculate the worksheet because every time you select a different cell, it will recalculate those values. So I'm just going to save this. I'm just going to close this, and don't worry if you don't have time to copy it. I will put this code in the description for you to copy later on, for you to try yourself. Okay, so I'm just going to go to File and select Close and Return. Now, there is a second step to this, and the second step requires some conditional formatting. So for step two, what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the entire worksheet, and then I'm going to select conditional formatting and select new rule, and then I'm going to select from the selected rule type, use a formula to determine which cells to format. And back to my notepad, we're going to use this formula. Now this formula, it compares the row or column number against the row or column number to be highlighted. Now we only need one of these to be true, which is why they're wrapped in an OR function. You can see the OR function being used here. And I'm just going to format this. Again, don't worry, I will copy this formula and paste it down in the description for you. So I'm going to select a format. This will be the color of the highlighted row and column. And fill, let's choose a bright blue color. Okay, and I'm going to select OK. Now you can see cell A1 was selected. So if I select another cell, you can see this working really well. And that's what is the combination of the Visual Basic code and the conditional formatting formula. Bye bye.